Alright. Excuse me. Alright, welcome back to Skyrim. Let's see. It's been a while since I last put out an episode. Reason for that is my old headset is broken. So, got this new fancy one. That cost about twice as much. So yeah. I actually tried to record an episode already with this headset, but, I was having problems with it. Like the first time I tried,
I'm going to check that out.
There wasn't any audio. Like any game audio. The second time I tried, it wasn't recording my voice. So now, I've tested it, so pretty sure it's working now. So in this episode, what I'm hoping to do is, I'm gonna do a Daedric quest before I go to Skyhaven Temple. Although maybe I should go to Skyhaven Temple, Skyhaven Temple first, because you get really good armor there. So, yeah, that would be useful. Yeah, I guess we'll do that first. And then we'll do some Daedric quests. Oh, look at that little chicken. Why is the chicken running towards the dragon? Think he was gonna fight him or something? That's one badass chicken. A pretty cool feature too. Like every time you kill a dragon in a town, everyone goes to gawk at it. Yeah, makes it feel more believable.
You and me. Some may call this junk. Me, I call them treasure.
Kind of bugs me a little bit is that, you know,
all right, then.
You're never really sure like how many people know you're Dragonborn. It's like some people just like have no idea. Some people suspect that you are, some people know. It's like you'd think that, you know, after you kill a dragon in a town, that, you know, word would spread really quick and everyone would know. But, not necessarily. But that's kind of a problem that I think, most of the Elder Scrolls games after Daggerfall have. Because, like, you know, you're some kind of legendary hero that's well known to everyone, but people don't necessarily treat you like you are. I see in like Arena and Daggerfall, it makes sense, and Morrowind too, for most of the main quest.
Need a ride? Where do you want to go?
Because, like, you know, you're on the down low, trying to keep it a secret from everyone that you're an agent of the Emperor.
Climb and back, and we'll be off.
But,
Ever been to Markarth? Some say it was built by the dwarves. I don't believe a word of it, though.
in this game, you know, there's no effort that you make or anyone else makes to conceal your identity. See, I think this is an iron mine over here. Gotta find all the iron mines that I can, because I wanna make lots and lots of jewelry. Notice how it says iron in parentheses. The vanilla game doesn't do that. That's a mod that I got. So it tells you which material you can get from every mine. It's really handy to see what kind of mine it is before, you know, instead of having to go in and see for yourself.
Fortune smiles upon this meeting. Take a look.
If I'll ever use those. Just sell these. I'm gonna use that alchemical stuff. I always forget that I have like these buff potions, and then I never end up using them because like I always want to save them for some occasion, but then I never find an occasion that I think is important enough to use them, so they just sit in my inventory. Same thing with the scrolls too. I should really just use them. Like if I ever get into trouble.
May your road lead you to warm sands.
All right. My gut is telling me to grab that Nurnroot root because there's some instinct that I have to grab shiny things. But I really will not have any use for it, so shouldn't do it.
Are you finished ogling the grotesque? I suppose I should be grateful you didn't simply attack me. I am one of the afflicted. I'd have been dead from this plague a year ago if not for Periite's protection.
Returning to High Rock, our shepherd lost his way, and I fear Periite's wrath may consume those who remain with him. Kesh could tell you more. I just want out of Skyrim as quickly as possible.
So that's another Daedric quest. Periite actually has a really good artifact, so I might end up doing that. In fact, I'm gonna go so far as to say that he has the most useful artifact. It's really good. I'm not gonna say what it is. I don't wanna spoil it. Good to just go around discovering stuff. Makes fast traveling quicker. Let's see, I'll just do some transmuting. It's another dragon. Yeah, usually what ends up happening here is you have to fight a bunch of Forsworn and a dragon at the same time. So it can get pretty hairy. What I could do is just, you know, fight the dragon first. But I don't have any cover, so that's not good. Oh dear. I think that's Esbern down there. Yeah, we got Esbern and Delphine to help me. See, what I should be using is this. I'll just switch between this and that. See, I think he attacks the Forsworn too, so I could kind of let him wear them down. Lots of strategizing you can do with the combat in this game. I like it. I kind of want him to attack me so I can use my ward. So if I do that, I can get more restoration skill.
Still be here,
so. Yeah, no shit. I mean, totally didn't see him kicking up all that dirt over here. This is what I was talking about. Actually, no, I don't think I mentioned it in the last part. He lost me. This is a pretty cool feature. He makes, you know, if he's in the middle of flying and you damage him, kind of like crash into the ground and make a big divot. Stronger than regular dragons. See, I'm not putting the ward up fast enough, so I'm not avoiding all the damage. Just being an idiot. Just use up all my potions, why not? And I'm out of magicka. Can I use this? Yes, I can. I think I have some shouts that I can spend on, or spend souls on. Yeah, I can become ethereal. Take these bones. Oh, I shouldn't have taken those arrows. I don't like those. These forsworn arrows are even worse than iron arrows. There's really no point. Nice to have binoculars right now. Or maybe a detect life spell. Let's see, what school of magic is that? Is that illusion? Why would that be illusion? That doesn't make sense.
So it wasn't my imagination.
I'm curious. Let's see, there's conjuration, destruction, restoration. I guess it would be alteration. Yeah. Used to be mysticism, but there's no such thing as mysticism now. Daedra heart. Nice. This is a pretty rare ingredient. It's pretty hard to find those. They're also really useful because you need them to make Daedric armor. You're typically not just going to find Daedric armor lying around. You have to make it yourself. But I won't be able to until a lot later. I have to make a lot more jewelry. So these are hagravens. It's kind of like a cross between a witch and a harpy. I think in one of the loading screens I called them like harpies that can't fly. Yeah, that describes them pretty well. So I think these Forsworn are all Bretons. I don't remember exactly how the lore goes with them. I think like they're Bretons that think that this land belongs to High Rock. I guess it has something to do with the Thalmor, I think. Not sure. You know what? Pretty sure there's a book that talks about them, so I'll just go find one of those.
Be careful. The Forsworn are just as dangerous as they look. I could use a hand here.
Is this friendly? It's friendly, okay. guess this is their sacrifice. Sacrifice to giant. Oh god, I'm about to sneeze. Excuse me. Let's see, 27. 27. Yeah, it's not as fast as my sword. There's a couple things to take into account when you're choosing your weapon. Satchel sword. Here it is. Because, like, you know, weapons all have different speeds that you can swing them at, and different damages. So it's a bit of a trade-off, you know. Like, if you want to be able to hit somebody a whole lot of times, then you might get more damage per second. But, you know, if you're fighting someone who blocks a lot, then it might be better to have, like, something that swings slower, like a mace. So then you can sneak some attacks in between their blocks. Do a whole lot of damage that way, with just a few swings. So. And also, you know, you can get perks that give you other advantages. Like, you know, if you use maces, you can bypass armor. And if you use axes, you can cause bleeding damage. So, like, you know, you do your initial amount of damage, and then your enemy will continue to take damage. It's kind of like the same effect as setting them on fire. I think I might need these for something. I'm not sure. But, the sword really has the weakest advantage from perks, because really all it does is make it so you can have critical strikes, and it's all completely random, you know. Like, some swings will be a critical strike, some swings won't. A critical strike doesn't even do that much more damage. And, you know,
let's keep moving.
Couple of that with the fact that swords do the least amount of damage. Your damage per second with swords is probably the lowest, even though they're the fastest to swing. So I generally prefer axes, because, you know, not every thing that you fight wears armor, so maces aren't always the best. But everything can take bleeding damage, so axes are usually the way to go, I think. These guys are pretty tough. Well, that guy wasn't. I think this is like, you know, usually the enemies are generated, but I think these are like pre-placed. Because usually, you know, you get enemies that have a level that's like close to your level. Sometimes you'll get enemies that are always the same level. So I think that Briarheart was like eternally a low level. Look at that. But usually Briarhearts are really, really tough. you know, if you're stealthy, then you can actually pickpocket their Briar Heart from them, and that instantly kills them. So I think that's pretty cool. They did a lot to make stealth viable in this game. In fact, it's probably a little bit too viable because you can get a perk that increases your sneak attack damage with daggers. You know, if you get a combination of perks, you can like raise it up to 15 times normal damage. So you know, if like you're dual wielding two daggers, then you get like it's like 30 times. So it's crazy.
These pillars must have something to do with it.
Yes. These are Akaviri symbols. Here, let's see. You had the symbol for king and warrior.
Whatever you did, it worked. Let's see what those old pillars left in our way.
I'm too smart for these people. These are the symbols from before, so you have to step on these. Because the other ones will make arrows shoot at you, I think. It's another one of Skyrim's brilliant puzzles.
Why are you stopping?
We should be careful here. See these symbols on the floor?
Look safe. Let's move.
Yes, yes. I think we must be close to the entrance.
Oh, this looks really nice, especially with the EMB.
One.
Little boss level chest here.
Remarkably well preserved, too. Ah, here's the blood seal, another of the lost Akaviri arts. No doubt it's triggered by, well, blood. Your blood, Dragonborn. Look
Dry
here.
Blood
you see
the
how the ancient blades revered Riemann Cyrodiil?
It's coming to life.
I couldn't really see it because I'm in first person mode, but. What your character does is he. Cuts his hand with a dagger. Something about that always makes me cringe, you know, like I've been swinging swords at people and, you know, making all sorts of blood spatter around, but something about, you know, cutting your palm, I don't know.
Almost entirely.
Just level up real quick. Eventually I want to increase my stamina. I use Magicka a lot, so you'd think, you know, it'd be important to increase Magicka, but you know, it's really more important to get magic perks, so you use a lot less. Can get one of these weapon specialization perks. I don't have a good axe yet, so I'm gonna hold off on that. I really should get some better restoration, I think. Unless I can increase one of these. What's my archery? Yeah, I need to do my restoration. be able to cast wards well, especially when I'm fighting dragons.
Amazing. You can see how the Akaviri craftsmen were beginning to embrace the more flowing Nordic style.
We're here for Alduin's wall, right, Esbern?
Yes. Let's see what's up ahead.
So while they're slowly walking up to it, I'm gonna go get some items. See, in this chest you get a full suit of blades armor. It's fairly decent armor. By the level I'm at, it's really good. No, I'm carrying too much, dang it. Alright, let's see, what can I put back in? Just put back in the fine steel armor. Steel helmet. Put all of it back in. Except I want to keep these. It's going to be hard to part with these iron gauntlets. Because I like doing that much more damage. Well, I guess in the meantime I can just wear the helmet, shield, and armor.
Early second era Kaviri sculpture in relief.
Yes, we need information, not a lecture on art history.
Yes, yes. Let's see what we have. Look, here is Ultiman. This panel goes back to the beginning of time, when Alduin and the Dragon Cult ruled over Skyrim. Here, the humans rebelled against their Dragon Overlord, the legendary Dragon War. Alduin's defeat is the centerpiece of the war. You see, here is fallen from the sky. The Nord Tongs, masters of the voice, are arrayed against him.
So does it show how they defeated him? Isn't that why we're here?
Patience, my dear. The Akaviri were not a straightforward people. Everything is couched in allegory and mythic symbolism. Yes, yes. This here, coming from the mouths of the Nord heroes, this is the Akaviri symbol for shout. But there's no way to know what shout is meant.
You mean they used a shout to defeat Alduin? You're sure?
Oh, yes. Presumably something rather specific to dragons. Or even Alduin himself. Remember, this is where they recorded all they knew of Alduin and Ulthur.
So we're looking for a shout, then. Damn it. You ever heard of such a thing? A shout that can knock a dragon out of the sky? You're probably right. I was hoping to avoid having to involve them in this, but it seems we have no choice. If they had their way, you do nothing but sit up on their mountain with them and talk to the sky, or whatever it is they do. The Greybeards are so afraid of power that they won't use it. Think about it. Have they tried to stop the Civil War, or done anything about Alduin? No. And they're afraid of you, of your power. Trust me, there is no need to be afraid. Think of Tiber Septim. Do you think he'd have founded the Empire if he'd listened to the Greybeards? Good. The Greybeards can teach you a lot, but don't let them turn you away from your destiny. You're Dragonborn, and you're the only one who can stop Alduin. Don't forget it.
Right. Good thing they've already let you into their little cult. Not likely they'd help Esbern or me if we came calling. We'll look around Skyhaven Temple and see what else the old Blades might have left for us. It's a better hideout than I could have hoped for. Talos guard you.
Look here, in the third panel. The prophecy which brought the Akaviri to Tamriel in the first place, in search of the Dragonborn. Here are the Akaviri, the blades. You see their distinctive long swords. Now they kneel, their ancient mission fulfilled, as the last dragonborn contends with Aldred at the end of time. Are you paying attention, Delphine? You might learn something of our own history.
I guess I could explore the temple a little bit. I think you can use this to light these. Nah. Mace etiquette. Ooh. So this is supposed to be a leveled weapon. So like, you know, the higher your level is, the more damage it does. But I have a mod that removes leveled item rewards. So this is the absolute best version of Dragonbane. And really it's a bit overpowered. At least Akaviri katanas. Cool. So I don't know, it kinda feels like cheating to use it now. But the reason I got that mod is because, you know, I always find it really frustrating when, you know, you are at a low level and you get a reward, but it's a crappy version of the reward. So, you know, if you don't wait until later to get it, then you're going to be stuck with the crappy one forever. So I don't really like that. I did have that really good mod in Oblivion. I don't know if there's an equivalent in this. That it levels up the items with you. So, you know, if you're low level and you get the crappy version, then it's okay, because, you know, if you level up, the item will level up too. But the closest thing I could find to that was a mod that just gives you the best version of all of the leveled items as soon as you find them. If there is an equivalent, I'm not going to get it during this playthrough, because I don't like to futz around with mods during the playthrough. I did that in the Oblivion Let's Play, and that ended up biting me in the butt. So I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to stick with what I have. Oh, I have to favorite my shield. Does it say that I'm carrying too much? So, before, it said that I wasn't carrying too much. What changed? I don't know. I wasn't paying attention. I don't need this corundum ingot. So, what am I doing now? I should talk to Arngeir. I'm not going to do that yet. I might just go ahead and do the Periite quest. Yeah. Just going to do that. But first, I need to sell some stuff. I'll go to Whiterun. Actually, you know, I should probably show you around Markarth. Markarth is pretty cool. It's definitely the most unique city, because the whole thing is basically one big Dwemer ruin.
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard. Vampire hunters or something in the old fort near Riften.
There's a scripted event that we're going to see in a second.
Pendant would look lovely on my person.
I was too late.
Oh, this pendant would look lovely on
Never should have come here.
Mercy.
Don't kill me. I bleed.
I die for my people.
By the divines, the Forsworn are here in the city.
Everyone, stay back. The mark.
City Guard have this all under control. There are no Forsworn here.
Oh, except for this guy.
Did you see
we'll handle happened? Things from here. Move along.
A Forsworn agent. Here in the city.
I said move along. The Forsworn are just a bunch of madmen. We have everything under control. Stay out of it.
God.
All right, then.
A woman attacked right on the streets. Are you all right? Did you see what happened? A Forsworn? Strange. Well, I hope the Eight give you more peace in the future, for what it's worth.
Oh, I think you dropped this. Some kind of note. Looks important. No. I was just getting some fresh air. Had one too many pints of mead at the Silver Blood Inn. My note? No, that's yours. Must have fallen out of your pocket. All right, then.
Did you see that, Batman?
So he's doing some kind of cloak and dagger thing. Let's meet him at the shrine.
A Forsworn agent. Here in the city.
I don't know. I think I'm gonna do that later. Let's see.
Need to get going. What is it?
So this is the end of Skyrim, where all of the Forsworn are, in the western end.
Did you hear all that noise out
there? It's right on the border with High Rock.
It's just the market rabble. We should get back to work. You there, if you're here to trade, step up to the counter. No, I'm not Arnleaf. Yes, I know it. Some may call this junk. Me? I call them treasures.
Okay. Did I buy these by accident? I think I might have.
Come back whenever you need something.
Alright, I guess I can start on the Periite quest now. Let's see. Way out there. I can at least start heading towards it. But first, I want to see if I can make some jewelry. I want to take every opportunity to do that.
Anyone seen entering or leaving? Any strange lights or unusual noises?
It's abandoned, and it's always been abandoned.
So that's another place to start a Daedric quest. I really like how they handled the Daedric quests in this game, because, like, in Oblivion, it was really formulaic. You just, you know, you go up to the shrine. You ask what offering you need to give it. You give the offering, Daedric tells you what to do. You do it, and then you're done. You know, it's different in this game. You don't just always just go up to a shrine.
Tassels. What is this?
Way more creative, I think.
A nail?
Is that what you call it? In the Legion, we would have called it. Useless. Look how brittle the metal.
Whoops. Did not mean to do that. Dang it.
I'm sorry. I just let it blow past. The forge gets so hot.
You thought what? You would skip a step, not heat the metal all the way through? Jesus. Now do it again. You strike the metal like a new mother giving her babe a light slap. Hit it harder.
I'm sorry, Jesus. I just flinch your
mouth. You can't dust out of your eye. It'll break when it.
What? Oh, I don't have any iron ore.
Finished.
Oh well.
Hit it harder.
Need a new blade? Take a look.
Oh, I think she can train me. Yeah, nice.
It's an honorable craft. I'll show you what I can.
Yeah, I can afford that.
Take a look.
So, do you have silver ingot? No, she doesn't have silver ingot. Damn.
Let me know if you need something forged.
Let's go down to the smelter then. I could have sworn she sold silver ingot.
Can't talk. Mullish will beat me if I stop working.
They don't like us talking to people when we work.
Where did I get all that corrosive
from? Busy with
from?
The smelter.
I spilled
oh, that's right. I was hitting corundum veins because I was looking for gems.
The Greybeards have summoned the Dragonborn to hide.
Got an axe here. Take a look.
She has a lot of, or just three pieces of iron ore.
All right.
Steal stuff.
I'm Gorz's assistant. I help you with the forge.
Turn up this music. He's playing Morrowind music right now. Relocate it. And then pick it up. Ha! It's not considered stealing to pick it up. Should be considered stealing to pick it up. Why they decided to make it so it's not. It's like back in Oblivion, if you grab anything that doesn't belong to you, you're immediately arrested. Let's see. Like this. This. And. This. Alright. So I guess next time I'll start the Periite quest. Till then.